Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil karim. وعن عطاء ابن ابي رباح قال حدثتني فاطمه امراه عمر ابن عبد العزيز. So عطاء ابن ابي رباح is a tabi'i. So he says that Fatima, the wife of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he was a khalifa from, he ruled from about 99 to 101 Hijri. أنها دخلت عليه. So Fatima, his wife, went to him wherever he was. فإذا هو في مصلاه يده على خده. So Umar ibn Abdul Aziz rahimahullah, his hand was on his cheeks like this. سائلة دموعه. And his heart was, tears were flowing from his eyes. فقلت, she said, يا أمير المؤمنين, ألشيء حدث, something happened? You're not even like, if he's praying salah, praying Quran, you can dua, he would understand that he's crying for the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's just sitting there, and he's got his hands on his cheek, and he's just crying. So she said, something happened? ألشيء حدث, are you crying because of something that happened? قال يا فاطمة. So Umar rahimahullah, he says, إني تقلدت أمر أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. I have taken the responsibility of the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فتفكرت في الفقير الجائع. I started thinking about, what about those poor Muslims? والمريض الضائع. Those people who are ill. No one to look after them. والعار المجهود. Those who don't have clothing and they can't earn enough to provide themselves with sufficient clothing or good enough clothing for the winter, for the hot weather. والمظلوم المقهور. Those people who are being wronged by other people, what about them? والغريب المأسور. Somebody who's been imprisoned because of a debt, he can't pay off his debt. Somebody who's been imprisoned unjustly, he can't get his voice heard. والكبير, the elderly. وذي العيال في أقطال الأرض. Those people who have lots of family, lots of children, they can't provide for them, they can't support them. I'm thinking about that, and that makes me cry. فعلمت أن ربي سيسألني عنه. Allah has made me the Khalifa. I am responsible for them. I have taken the leadership of the Muslimun, and Allah will ask me regarding the day of Qiyamah. Now, and all of these are the Muslims. These are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I fear that the day of Qiyamah, khasamahum dunahum Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On the day of Qiyamah, the lawyer or the attorney for all of these people with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'll be the guilty party. But the Prophet will say that, oh Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, you were in charge of the whole Ummah. You're responsible for the Ummah. What about these poor, the weak, the sick, the oppressed? Why did you not look after them? Why did you not sort them out, help them? فَخَشِيْتُ أَلَّا تَثْبُتَ لِي حُجَّةٌ إِنْدَ خُصُومَتِهِ. I'm just scared that I will have no answer. I will have no answer. So it's a very, very great lesson from top to bottom. The Prophet ﷺ says, "Kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'oolun an ra'iyatihi." Each one of you will be questioned. Each one of you is a shepherd, meaning everybody has a responsibility. So like Umar ibn Aziz rahimahullah, he was responsible for the entire ummah. But every one of us, to a certain extent, we have responsibility for those under us. As a parent, as a teacher, as an imam, as an elderly in the family, all of the things, we are all responsible in some way or other for other people, and we will be questioned on the day of Qiyamah regarding this. كلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. So with responsibility, it's a very great responsibility. And I always say to you know, when we look around the world, we are very quick, and it's true, to criticize, like, oh, this leader is doing this and this leader is doing that. Look how much money they're wasting here. Look how much money they're wasting there. But if we look at ourselves, if we were to scale up our life, so we say, oh, they're wasting millions on this one trip. They're wasting billions on this. But if we were to look at our own lives, we don't waste billions, we don't have billions. We don't waste millions, we don't have millions. We waste £5, £10, £15. Because that's all we have. So if we were that rich, we'd probably waste the same amount as they would. When if you go somewhere, I know sometimes we go, like we're traveling and we go to one of those countries where they have a very, very unprofessional system at the airport. And it's like standing in one line, they close the gates, and you get there. It's like, what's going on here? You get so angry, you get so upset. They treat you, it's like, khalas, go. It's like, where should I go? You get so upset, you get so angry, and like, you know, you're not talking to us properly, you're not giving us proper, why can't I do it? But if you look, if we're in charge of a madrasa, and a student comes to us and he got a complaint, and we just reject them, just like that, we're in the same boat, aren't we? There's a saying, كُلُّ يُحِبُّ الْعَدْلَ كُلُّ يُحِبُّ الْعَدْلَ. Everybody wants justice. Everybody wants justice and fairness. إِلَّا عَلَيْهِ. Except when it doesn't suit you. So when I go to another country, or when I go to another place, I want to be treated fairly and properly and with respect. But when I am asked to do the same thing, we don't do that. You understand? So many times. So wherever we see, it's very easy to see the things that other people are doing. So our parents are being like this to us, for example. But then we've got a younger brother, younger sister. Are we being unfair to them? Are we bullying them? You understand? So we have to look at ourselves. Yes, those above us, if we can, call them to task, question them within the legal framework or whatever. But let's look at ourselves. We are also responsible for so many things. Are we fulfilling our responsibility? And this is what made the Khulafa'i Kiram so great. The earliest cause that they had this self, the muhasaba, they would account themselves for their responsibilities. They wouldn't think I'm an authority, so now I have lots of choice and I can do whatever I want. They would always be worried that I am in authority, so I'm going to question the Qiyamah. So when you have privileges, you have a position. You don't think that you don't have a granted. You take that as a responsibility. Whatever you have, if you're the muazzin in the masjid, then make sure you give the azan on time. That's a responsibility. Don't delay. You're imam, make sure you fulfill that job properly. You're a teacher, make sure you fulfill that job properly. If you're somebody entrusts you with the child or the children to learn, then it's a responsibility. You have to make sure that their time is spent properly. Somebody entrusts you with anything. So you're in charge of a waqf. You make sure the money is spent properly. So wherever you're working at a till. You make sure that you're at a job, at a shop. You can make sure that you fulfill that job properly. Any job you have. You shouldn't only do a job because somebody's overlooking me. That's your mas'uliyah. You understand? So whatever job you have, whatever responsibility you have, make sure you fulfill it. So yes, Umar ibn Aziz rahimahullah, he's crying for the very, very top. And he has many, many responsibilities. But every one of us, either now or later on, you will come into a position where you're in authority. And you will also be questioned. You should also have the same worry. You understand? So don't think, I'm not in charge of the whole ummah. I'm not in charge of a whole masjid. I'm not in charge of a whole waqf. I'm not in charge of a whole... But you have your family accounts, family expenses. Are you wasting so much money on yourself where you could be spending on the whole family collectively? Are you fulfilling responsibility in the class? Are you talking? Are you wasting time? Are you doing mutala properly as a teacher? Somebody has some, your parents are spending money on you to paying your fees, they're paying your books. That's a mas'uliyah, that your parents are spending money on you, how much ever fees they're paying. Are you studying properly? Are you wasting your time? Are you studying properly? That's also, you ask, look, your parents have so much money on you. What did you do with this? So every aspect, you have a responsibility. So make sure you fulfill your responsibility. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to accept. Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanallah, wa bihamdika, wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, wa nastaghfiruka, wa natubu ilayka.